So thank you, madam, for a lengthy introduction. So first of all, respected chairman Sri M. Lakshman Reddy sir, and executive director Sri G. Chandrasekhar Yadav sir, and chief guest of today's program, Dr. T. Ramasri, who is a professor and HOD of ECE department from SV University Tirupati, and convener of this program, Dr. B. Hari Krishna, professor and HOD of ECE department, and program coordinators Professor Venkanna Moodu as well as Professor S. Ravi Kumar, and all the advisory committee member and the organizing committee members like Dr. A. Anand, Dr. Chaitanya, Dr. Tirupati, Ramesh Reddy, and Upender, Manikanta, Mrs. Anita, Mr. K. N. V. Rao, and Mrs. Lakshmi Priyanka, and Kiran Mai, and Kirtana, and Divya Vani, and all the staff member, teaching and non-teaching staff member, who had worked day and night to bring this concept into reality, and all the other HODs, deans, and invited guests, and last but not the least, participant across the country, a very good morning to all of you. So I am Dr. Santosh Kumar Patro, principal of St. Martin Engineering College. Wholeheartedly, I would like to welcome you all this 1 week STTP program, which is sponsored by AICT and titled as Medical Image Processing and its Application in Automated Disease Detection. So today we are starting the program and it is scheduled up to 24th of April. So my sincere appreciation and congratulations to the department, because based on my knowledge goes, if we will start calculating, last year from March 16th, the lockdown was imposed and the department is quite active and vibrant even though during the lockdown period, and they have taken all cares so that the teaching learning process and as well as the research portfolio of the faculty and the department should not be diluted at any cost. So they have taken lot of interest and lot of hard work, and finally, I think based on my knowledge goes, today is their 7th online event what they are hosting it, and past 6 events are massive success, and I wish to the Department of ECE and also the convener of the program, Dr. Hari Krishna, all the very best, and this program also should be a grand success by the active involvement and participant by the all the participants. So finally, if you look into the title, I am quite impressed with the title, because it is talking about the medical image processing and its application in automated disease detection. See, for the past more than 1 year, we all were talking and hearing about different kind of diseases, and we do not know how to deal with those diseases. So in this era, in case if any title or any subject discussion is proposed which is related to healthcare and which is related to this pandemic and all, it is quite very interesting, and also it is a very open area for all this kind of recent research for all the scholars. So as the title suggests, medical image processing. So normally if we discuss about the concept of medical image processing, means we could able to understand the X-ray and CT scan. CT scan is known as your computed tomography scan, and MRI, magnetic resonance imaging scan, ultrasound scan. These are all different type of images what normally we get it when we go for the healthcare unit. So here the title says, by using all these images, it will help us to detect our disease. So it is quite interesting, and when I was reading some of the article, and I could able to understand, today we have a AI diagnostic tool which is used to distinguish COVID-19 patient from other type of pneumonia within a second by analyzing the chest CT scan of a patient. So the CT scan of a chest is used to identify the severity of this COVID-19, and also it confirms it is not other kind of diseases as it is, you know, identified as COVID-19. And because of this early detection, it is possible to diagnose the disease, isolate the patient, and plan for a proper treatment cycle so that we can control this epidemic. And another article I was reading where it was written, by using the chest X-ray, again, this deep learning model is developed to detect COVID-19 positive cases and accelerate the treatment who needs it very urgently. And also there is an article who talks about several AI-based computer vision camera systems are deployed across different part of the country, and so that it scans the images from the crowd and it identifies whether any person from the crowd is symptomatically COVID-19 patients or not. So these are all, lot of growths are happening in the medical image imaging area, and lot of researches are going on, and still we want more knowledge, and lot of R&D activities should happen in this area so that it will come out in the form of a product or in the form of a service for the mankind. So with this note, I really appreciate the entire department of ECE who has taken interest of bringing out this title. And also I was going through the resource person. I really appreciate, because all the resource persons are master in their field, and the knowledge matrix, what we are going to get it, it is going to be very much useful. And I really appreciate and extend my thankfulness to AICTE, because this is the third AICTE funding activity we are doing within this 15 days of time, and remaining another 6 AICTE funded FDPs already we have received from AICTE. So very next week and subsequently in further next week and all, within 2 months of time, we are planning to complete all these remaining 6. So finally, I would like to appreciate, and also I would like to convey my sincere thankfulness to the chief guest of today's program, Dr. T. Ramashri, and who has taken all interest, and with our limited time period intimation, she could kind enough to grace this occasion, and she has given his consent, and today she is with us. So we appreciate you, madam, for your availability. And finally, I request all the participants, let us take this opportunity in the form of learning, and let us learn whatever the best way it is all possible. And finally, the motive of AICTE as well as St. Martin, because the knowledge what the teacher gains, finally, it has to be disseminated to the student, and it should go for the mankind and for the benefit of the society. So, and also the organizer have planned to capture your attendance. So I request all the participants to be active and be present for all the sessions and all, so that you will not have any issues for getting your certificate as well as, other attendance and all these protocols, which are all we need to follow to fulfill the guidelines of AICTE. So finally, thank you very much for the opportunity, and I wish all the very best to participant as well as organizers and the entire team of ECE department for bringing out this novel concept and for bringing out this 1 week program for the benefit of the society. Thank you once again, and thank you for the opportunity. Have a great day ahead. Thank you.